church this morning at Sunday school, I know four people just lately that God has healed of cancer. My niece Angel, Amy's birth mother, Lisa's brother Johnny, my brother-in-law, they said he was clear of cancer, my sister Joyce, and Diane Wheaton, good friend of our church. That's four people that God has worked miracles for just lately, healing of cancer. And you know, we think a lot of times, we really don't think, you know, we don't see miracles every day, or we don't think we do, and hear of miracles, but God is working miracles every day. You know, He woke us up this morning. You know, only He could have done that, you know, to wake us up. That's a miracle. We don't think of it, but it is. That's major miracles. You know, cancer, different people, different kind of cancer. But I just thank God for His healing power, and not just His healing power, His saving power, most of all. Some glad morning when the clock is on, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away in the morning when I hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. When the shadows of His life have grown, I'll fly away. Like a bird from prison bars have flown, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh when I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Somebody else have a song.
Thank you, Jesus.
I think my wife does.
Thank you, Jesus.
I have a testimony. Amen. Amen. Somebody else. The word tells us where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
That's right.
You have liberty to be able to testify. I like to thank God for everything He's done for my wife and myself.
Amen.
Time and time again, we've been up against the wall, didn't know how we was going to make it. But you know what? Little as much when God is in it, and God makes a way when there seemeth to be none.
That's right.
Many times He's opened doors for us. Sometimes we didn't know where our next meal was coming from. But on the spot, God opened up a door, made sure we had a truckload of groceries brought to us. You've just been good to us.
Amen.
Love the Lord. Thank Him for everything that He's done and everything He's going to do.
Amen.
God is good.
Amen.
I praise God for all His blessings of this year, 2019. And, you know, I just praise God because, you know, He's brought me a long ways. And, you know, I just going to give Him the praise, you know, and the honor. He said if He be lifted up, you know, we've got to lift up Jesus. Everything else in this world has been lifted up with Jesus, but I want to lift Jesus up. In 2020, I want to lift Jesus up more, and I want to behold because He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Yes, He's come back after a people that's looking for Him, and He's coming back after a people without spot, wrinkle, or blemish. And you know, we've got to shake off these old shingles and put on the whole new army of God. And you know, we can't let people hinder us. You know, a lot of people get up and, you know, they like to throw mud and stuff like that. But, you know, none of us perfect. If we did, you know, that's why the Bible said to pray every day. We got to pray and ask the Lord. If we done something to offend anybody, to forgive us. Because we got to love one another. Because there ain't going to be no party in heaven. It's going to be one heaven and one hell. And I want to make it. And I want to have that love for my brothers and sisters. Uh-huh. And, you know, I want to stand before Him, and I want to hear Him say, well done. And y'all pray for me and all my family. And I love every one of you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
There's a broken man I know, barely holding on to hope.
Bless the Lord.
Trying to get back up from his last fall.
Everybody faces a storm now and then. So if God is moving right now. Stand still.
do it.
They don't know what keeps me going. I guess they never have met you. My life was in shambles till the day you came along. You turned my tears into laughter. You gave me a brand new song.
Yes, Lord.
I'm still holding on. Lord, I'll never let you go.
That's right.
You gave me a smile. You touched my heart, you touched my soul. The bridges left behind me, Lord, I burned them to the ground. Lord, I'm still holding on. You're the best thing I ever found. Oh, boded likely not to prosper. I was left hanging over my head. You'll never count for nothing. That's what those people said. I've been known to be unsettled. Never stayed around too long. You're the treasure I was searching for, and Lord, I'm still holding on. I'm still holding on. Lord, I'll never let you go. You gave me a smile. You touch my heart, you touch my soul, and the bridges left behind me. Lord, I burned them to the ground. Lord, I'm still holding on. You're the best thing I ever found. Bridges left behind me. Lord, I burned them to the ground. Lord, I'm still holding on. You're the best thing I ever found. Lord, I'm still holding on.
Well, I know I'm unworthy of.
life to him. I got so much to thank him for. And I got so much to thank him for. So much to praise him for. Well, you see, he's been so good to me. He's brought me from, I got so much to thank him for. And sometimes, along this way, I kneel. I stop and say, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. And one day I'll reach heaven's shore. Oh, please let me kneel once more. I got so much to thank him for. And I've got so much to thank him for. So much to praise him for. What you see, he's been so good to me. Of what he's done and where he's brought me from, I got so much to thank him for. And when I pray, I think of what he's done and where he's brought me from, I got so much to thank him for.
Walk around me, Jesus. Walk around me, Jesus. Walk around me, Jesus. Walk around. Walk around my bedside, Lord. Before Mama died, she called me to her bedside. Told me that the Lord had been walking all around. I can hear her singing, walk around me, Jesus, walk around.
Walk around me, Jesus, walk around me, Jesus, walk around me, Jesus, walk around.
Walk around when I am praying.
Anybody else have a song?
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Thank God for His Spirit. Thank you for His presence here tonight. And if I could find the offering basket, I would take up an offering.
Praise the Lord. They're married, no words at.
Would you like to say the blessing over the offerings? Brother Webb, would you like to say the blessing over the offering?
Yes, bless. Thank you, Lord, for everybody here to give offering for me. You have a million up to give. Lord, bless the service of the Lord. Ask for Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you all. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord, I get the feeling of the Spirit of God in a song like that, and I can just see myself spiritually dancing all over.
Amen.
God is good.
Thank you, Lord.
I guess at this time I'll turn it over to Brother Rick. Let him come and preach us mad or happy one. Praise the Lord.
No rocks on Praise the Lord. Give the Lord a big old hand clap.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Better turn that thing down.
Well, everybody's here drunk. I got a big mouth anyway. But you know God's good. Amen. All He is to keep from
straining my voice too much. Amen.
Hallelujah.
After so many years,
your voice gets a little bit strained. Amen. Hallelujah.
I about lost my voice a time or two, amen, but let me tell you something. I was going to lose it. I'd rather be losing it for the Lord, amen, than lose it for anything else, amen. But I tell you, God's a good God, amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Heavenly Father, we thank you and we praise you, Lord, for your presence and the songs of Zion tonight, Lord. Lord, I feel in my spirit you got something for us tonight, God. And I know, Lord, this is the last Sunday of 2019. And if you let us all live, Lord, soon we'll be in 2020, Lord. And we just thank you, Lord, for blessings throughout this year and keeping us, Lord, and watching over us, Lord. And we praise you for that, Lord. And Lord, I just ask tonight, God, that you just anoint me with your Spirit. Fill my mouth with your words, Lord, and use me for thy will tonight, God, to bring glory to your name. Lord, I know I'm nothing without you. Can't do anything without you. Can't preach. Can't do anything. Can't even take my next breath without you, oh God. And God, I'll give you the glory for everything. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm thankful to be here tonight. Amen. You know, God's good to us, folks. Amen.
Amen.
Even when we don't deserve it. Amen. Even when, glory to God, all we would deserve to glory to God is judgment and wrath, but glory to God, yet, because of Jesus, He shed forth His grace and His mercy upon us. Amen.
Yes.
And I thank Him for that tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. If you have your Bibles tonight, I've preached this before. The Lord's laid this on my heart for the last week to preach once again. Amen. And I think we need to come to an awakening in the church. We need to come to an awakening that this thing's not about my ability tonight or your ability, but it's about Jesus Christ and what He done at Calvary. How many knows that tonight? Amen. You can't earn your salvation tonight. I believe in living right, believe in living clean, believe in living holy and righteous before the Lord. But you can do your best to do all those things, but yet slip somewhere down the line and fall short of His glory. Amen. Hallelujah. But if we get our faith and Jesus Christ and Him crucified. See, Paul, they didn't like to hear Paul preach. Come on now, because he preached Jesus to them. He preached Jesus Christ and Him crucified. What are you saying? He weren't preaching that Jesus was still on that cross, but he was preaching the work that took place at Calvary on that cross. the finished work of Calvary. Let me tell you something right now. There's some that's struggling with sin and struggling with drugs, alcohol, and everything else. And they're trying to overcome these things. But the only way it can be done is through the cross. It's through the cross. I'm here to tell you that tonight, through the cross. Whatever you're battling with tonight, the only way it can be overcame is through the cross. That's where our victory lies at tonight. Hallelujah. The Galatians had some coming in, and they were telling them, I'm fixing to read in just a moment, that they had to keep the law to be saved. Had those coming in, you got to do this, you got to do that to be saved. And they took the focus off of Jesus and put it on self. Come on now. That's where we're at in the church world today, believe it or not. The focus is off of Jesus, but on self now. What I can do, what I have to do to become this or that. Let me tell you something. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something right now. There's not a one of us that could pay for our own sins. Not a one of us. Our blood was tainted with sin, but the blood of Christ atoned for our sins. He was lamb without spot, without blemish. No gall, no filth was found in his mouth. He was holy in every area. I mean, every place. Perfect. Come on now. The perfect lamb that went to Calvary for you and I and shed his blood that we might be able to be born again and called the children of God. Come on. Hallelujah. Galatians chapter 1, first verse. Paul, an apostle, not of men, neither by man, but by Jesus Christ and God the Father who raised him from the dead. And all the brethren which are with me unto the churches of Galatia, grace be to you and peace from God the Father and from our Lord Jesus Christ, who gave himself for our sins, that he might deliver us from the present evil world according to the will of God and our Father, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. I marvel that ye are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel. Come on now. Which is not another, but there be some that trouble and would pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. See, Paul didn't play around with us. Let them be accursed. Come on now. For do I now persuade men or God, or do I speak to please men? For if I yet pleased men, I should not be the servant of Christ. Come on now. What are we preaching for? Why are we telling them about Jesus? It's not to please man, but it's to be the servant of Christ. Come on now. Hallelujah. Paul was telling them, you had received the message of the cross, but they be some that's come in and they have perverted the gospel. They have twisted it and turned it. Add it to it. Come on. The gospel's simple. Jesus Christ and him crucified. It's simple, Brother Mitchell. The cross. The preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness. But to us that are saved, it is the power of God. What other gospel is there? That's it. He came and he died for you and I. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He came down from glory, put on a flesh suit. God manifested in the flesh. Humbled himself. Hung on that cross. Some says it was like this, some says it was like this. All I know, he was nailed to a cross. Yes. And I know that he shed his blood. Humbled himself. My, why? Because he looked down and he seen his creation polluted with sin, polluted with all evil and all uncleanness, all unholiness, all the filth and the imaginations of man was just dirty and filthy. There's no hope for them. Unless I go and die with him. See, it was predestinated before the foundation of the world that Christ should come and die for you. We sing that old song, there's power, power, wonder-working power in the blood. Oh, glory. If we only realized and believed it tonight, we could walk out of this place healed. We could walk out of this place set free from all bondage. We could step out that door. I'm free. I'm free because of the shed blood at Calvary. I'm free. I'm free because he died for me and rose again on that third and glorious day. I'm free. I'm free because his blood atoned for my sins. My victory lies in what he done for me. Not in what I can do, but in what he has done. Come on. Come on. We can't earn the things of God. Too many are trying to earn what God has for them. A gift is a gift. A gift is a gift. For God so loved the world that he gave. We just come out of Christmas season. Well, let me tell you something. He gave his only begotten son the best gift that he could give. To come and to die for you and I at Calvary. Yeah, church world, run them drug addicts down. You're running the ones down that God came for. Run them drunkards down. You're running the ones down that God came for. Instead of running them down, you need to be going out there and pulling them out of the pits of hell and telling them that God loves them, that Jesus died for them. Come on now. Hallelujah. I'm tired of what I'm seeing in the church world tonight. Some of you need to get off your pedestal, off your high horses, and come down to earth and know you're nothing without Christ. I don't care what position you sit in today. You need to come down and humble yourself before God and know, Lord, I'm nothing without you. And there's a lost and dying world out there that needs your gospel. Not what I can do, but what you've already done, Lord. Come on. Hallelujah. They perverted the gospel. They perverted the truth. Hallelujah. Come on now, but Paul was clear on it. He didn't pull no punches. He was straight up on it. Come on now. But though we, he meant himself and all the apostles, but though we are an angel, come on now, from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. What are you saying? Let him be accursed. Let him be damned. That's what it means. That's what it means. Come on. Got too many displaying. Too many display in church. But I believe the days of playing is over. I said it a few years ago, there's a time coming, there's a shaking that's been going to take place, and I believe it's been taking place. And what's happening, the shaking is going to separate the real from the false. Because when it when it's over, all that's going to be standing is the real. Those that's got their faith in Jesus, those that's got their eyes on Him and got their mind made up, it don't matter who likes me, who don't like me, who comes against me or whatever, or tries to put stumbling blocks, I'm going on for my Jesus just the same. I'm not giving up. I'm not quitting. I'm not stopping. I'm going on for Jesus. Come on. Somebody need to hear me tonight. It's time that the church wakes up and realize that it's the blood, that it's the blood, that it's the blood, that it's the blood, that it's the blood that was shed at Calvary that atones for your sins and gives you the victory. Come on. The blood. The blood. Hallelujah. Come on now. Hallelujah. See, He told them over in chapter 5, first verse, stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Religion will put chains on you. Man-made religion. Come on, somebody hear me tonight. Man-made religion will put chains on you and pull you into bondage. There's no liberty in man-made religion. There's no freedom in man-made religion. There's no deliverance in man-made religion, because it all lies in the finished work of Calvary. Whew, I feel the anointing tonight. Stand fast! Huh? Therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free. Christ hath made us free. Somebody hear me now. Christ hath made us free. Not some preacher, not some man, but Christ, God manifested in the flesh, has made us free from the yoke of bondage. Come on! Christ. Take your chains, I don't need them. Somebody else, take the chains, I don't need them. Don't try to put that on me. Christ set me free. Don't try to put that on me. Christ set me free. They'll come at you with a chain. But you got to do so and so. Christ done it. Yes, I know I got to live right. But I'm living right because of Him. I'm living right because He's given me the ability to do so, the desire to do so, the want to do so. If you ain't got the desire to live right tonight, then something's wrong. You need to get on your knees and have a little talk with Jesus. If that fire, that desire in you ain't there to live for Jesus, then something's matter. You need to take that banner down. Hallelujah. And get on your knees and say, Lord, help me to be who You called me to be. Help me to be God, who You ordained me to be, God. Help me, God, to get in and all sin, anything that may be hindering me, to get it out of my life and get my eyes on You, Jesus. Help me, oh God, to get my eyes on You, Jesus. Yes. Man will build you up and then pull the props out from under you. But Jesus will build you up and exalt you. But first you got to abase. You got to humble yourself. Then when you humble yourself, then He can exalt you. You don't want Him to humble you. It's better to humble yourself. We correct our children, and they don't like it. When God corrects us, we won't like it either. But it's for our own good. How many knows that? It's for our own good. But those that exalt themselves, God will abase. But those that humble themselves, He will exalt in due season. Behold, I, Paul, say unto you that if ye be circumcised, Christ shall profit you nothing. For I testify against every man that is circumcised that he is a debtor to the whole law. Come on now. He's trying to teach them that you do not have to keep the law to be born again. Now, mind you, the law was holy and perfect. It weren't done away with. It was fulfilled by Christ. And the law is kept now, this day, when we put our faith in Jesus, got our eyes on what he done for us, it's kept by him living through us. You can try to keep the law, and it was more than just the Ten Commandments. That's what we've been taught. But it was more than just the Ten Commandments. 400 and something Mosaic laws. Come on now. And if you broke one, you broke the entire law at all. You broke it all. And mind you, Gentiles, we didn't even have no covenant till Christ came and died for us. Gentiles were considered as dogs, filthy, unclean. Jewish folk were not allowed, lawfully allowed, to keep company with those of another nation. Come on now. So, you can try to keep that law if you want to, but you're going to break it. You're going to slip, you're going to break it. And I'm not telling you to go out and sin and look at the, well, I'm going to do what I know. That ain't what I'm saying. I'm saying you better get your eyes on Jesus is what I'm saying. And then it will be kept. You won't have to worry about it. It will be kept if your eyes are on him. Come on now. Somebody need to hear me tonight. He said, behold, I, Paul, say unto you that if you be circumcised, Christ shall profit you nothing. For I testify again to every man that is circumcised that he is a debtor to do the whole law. You try to keep it one point, you got to keep it all. You got to keep it all. You're a debtor to the whole law. Then what does he say here? Christ is become of no effect unto you. Whosoever of you are justified by the law. Now, this is not a very popular part of it. Ye are fallen from grace.
That's not popular, is it, Brother Mitchell? I know we use that concerning things out in the world, but simply turning your faith from Christ and him crucified to your own ability to make yourself righteous, to your own ability to save yourself, you have given up grace. You have fallen from grace. Because you're saying, Lord, what you've done for me weren't good enough. I got to try to do it myself. Woo!
Let's not try to do this ourselves. Let's keep our eyes on him.
Yes.
Live clean, yes. I don't. Grace is not a license to sin. It's not a license to sin. But if I do slip and I sin, the Bible says I got an advocate with the Father, Christ Jesus, the righteous one. And I can hit my knees and ask for forgiveness and be forgiven. And you can too. Come on. Brother Mitchell, I've been guilty of it. I've hung yokes of bondage around people's necks. And when they couldn't meet up to that label I thought they should, I would cut them off. That's not right. You're God's heritage. You're God's. You belong to him. We're not supposed to judge the work before it's finished either. I might see where you're at right now. But God sees you at the ending.
When he looks, see, we're in Christ. Christ is in us. When he looks,
he sees Jesus. Because of Calvary. See, I went through years of condemnation. I went through years of the devil yelling in my ear, condemning me. I went through years of him telling me that I couldn't preach. I went through years of him telling me I weren't educated enough. And here lately, he's been trying to tell me that you ain't educated enough. Let me tell you something. That's right. And I'm glad I'm not educated, my man, because I spent a little bit of time with the Holy Ghost, and he educated me. Come on now. How did he teach you? Let me tell you something. He teaches you. Glory to God. And I thank God for everything that he's taught me today. I thank God for him opening my eyes even more and more to things, helping me have more and more understanding. Glory to God, this thing's about Jesus Christ and him crucified. It's not about me. It's not about my ability or my strength, but it's about Jesus. And if somebody will grab a hold of this tonight, you can go free. You can stop beating yourself up and say, Lord, here I am. I need deliverance. And I know my deliverance is in that finished work of Calvary. I know my victory is in that finished work of Calvary. And we preach more about the blood. If we preach more about Jesus Christ and him crucified, we'll start seeing the strongholds that's holding our kids' bondage to drugs and alcohol, pornography, and every other ungodly thing. We'll see them break.
Amen.
The early church didn't have offices set aside for psychology. Or rehabs. And I'm not being mean. I'm glad we got rehabs. Don't take me wrong. Why are you glad? Because the church ain't doing what they're supposed to be doing, so it's got to be taken care of.
Oh.
But if we get to where we're supposed to be, Brother Mitchell, there won't be no need for rehabs. Because people will be going free. They'll be bringing their people to church to get off the drugs. They'll be bringing their people to church to get off the alcohol and all that stuff. And we'll just get in the place that we should be. Our focus on Jesus. And then we'll lift him up. Because he said if he'll be lifted up, he'll draw all men nigh. I'm not talking about lifting up man. I'm not talking about lifting up titles. I'm not talking about lifting up church names. I'm talking about lifting up Jesus tonight. Glory to God. That's what I'm talking about tonight. Lifting the one up who came and died for you and I. That's who I'm talking about tonight. Well, preacher, I don't like that kind of preaching. Well, that's fine. Plug your ears, because I'll continue to preach Jesus, 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 the one who came and died for you and I. Come on. Hallelujah. For we through the Spirit wait for the hope of righteousness by faith. For in Jesus Christ neither circumcision availeth anything, nor uncircumcision, but faith which worketh by love. Those things availeth nothing, but faith which worketh by love. What's the matter with the faith in the church? Well, one thing, the love's died. Stone cold. He said, in the last days, the love of many shall wax cold. We're in the last days. You expect it in the world. You expect that coldness out there. But it's came to the doors to the church. And we've grown cold. If you ain't got money, then we don't want you. If you don't look like me, you don't dress like me, then we don't want you. You're not good enough. Come on now. I'm just being honest tonight. I don't care if your clothes has got holes in them. I don't care if you smell like you've been wallowing in a hog's pen. Come in. God loves you. I've been offset different from some, Judy. I'll accept you whatever shape you're in. Yeah, I've had some characters, you better believe it. But I've seen God do a work on them too. I've seen God do a work in them. I've had them come under a tent drunk. Why wouldn't you turn them? Why, no, why in the world would I turn them away? That's the one Jesus came to seek and save. I had one come in one time in revival. I was a young preacher up in 900 Knox Valley, a young preacher. Hadn't been pastoring long. Had some more young preachers. He come in, he didn't have no shirt on. He had blue jean shorts cut off, no shoes. It was back there, I talked to him. They said, Pastor, come here. We don't know what to do. Come here. I thought to myself, Lord, I don't know what to do either. But I went back there and the Holy Ghost came upon me and I looked that man straight in the eyes. And I asked him if he was ready to give his life to the Lord, if he was ready to go that altar. And let me tell you something, tears come in that man's eyes and that disturbing spirit that he had. It went and he started crying and he went to the altar and he knelt down in the altar. Let me tell you something. I could have looked at him and said, man, you ain't got no shirt on. Get out of this door. Out of this door. You got shorts on. But let me tell you something. I would have been turning away one that God was reaching for. Yes. Watch who you turn away. Watch who you shove out them doors. Yeah, they might not have the fancy clothes. They might not look like you. Come on now. They may have come from a rough background and they ain't got all their I's dotted and all their T's crossed just yet. And they may lose their temper and cuss you out in the parking lot. Then turn around and say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm trying to get better. Come on now. Don't turn them away, but love them. Love them. Faith works by love. Come on now. You got to love them. That's the problem now. We got to stop building man's kingdom and start working in the kingdom of our Lord Jesus Christ and start showing people the love of Christ once again. Yes, preach against sin. Yes, preach against those things. Yes, hold up a standard, but at the same time, have your arms open wide and say, come on in. Come on in. Jesus loves you. He'll clean you up from the inside out. See, we got the church world today. They got it cleaned up from the outside down, from the head to their toes. On the outside, they look like they got it, but on the inside, they ain't clean. Jesus told them, glory to God. Hallelujah. He told them, glory to God, that on the inside, they were like white sepulchers. They looked all good on the outside, but on the inside, they were full of dead man's bones. All the uncleanness. The Pharisees looked the part. They had the part. They looked the part. They had the clothes. They went through the rituals. They went through all the routines. They did everything they're supposed to be doing. But on the inside, they were unclean. The only one that can clean the inside up is Jesus Christ.
He told him, said, I'll make you fisher.
Fisher of men. Brother Mitchell, we got to catch them and let God clean them. We got to catch them. See, God showed me this years ago. He's reminded me of some things. He showed me this years ago. We got too many preachers that's doing the job of the Holy Ghost. They're trying to clean them up. Let God clean them up. See, I used to be long-haired, bearded hippie. I know that's hard to believe, man. I came to church here. I got someone who can witness it. I came to church here. And I went to church one place. This preacher, he was a holiness apostolic preacher. My heart, I didn't have everything together on the outside just yet, but my heart was toward Jesus. I was the only one long-haired, bearded preacher in that church. That preacher cut loose that night, talking about the long-haired hippies with beards. Everybody in that church, I was about that big. I seen them start turning around, everybody looking at me, they know. He could easily have killed me, though, and drove me away from Jesus. Yeah, it hurt. Because I went to church looking for something. I went to church looking for the love of God, acceptance. I didn't have all my I's dotted and all my T's crossed, but my heart loved Him. Be careful who you pass judgment upon. And come to find out that St. Mary preacher was condemning me. He done been married 9 or 10 times. Now come on now. Need to clean up from his own doorstep. Come on now. Hallelujah. You did run well. Who did hinder you that you should not obey the truth? This persuasion cometh not from him that called you. It didn't come from God. It didn't come from God. A little leaven leaveneth the whole lump. Just a little bit. Huh? You take a little of yeast.
That dough will rise.
Just take just a little bit of all keep it. And try to mix it with grace. Huh?
It don't work. It don't work.
What'll happen? You'll get your eyes off the cross. You'll get your eyes off of Jesus. And your focus will be on self and your own ability. That's what'll happen. You'll give up grace. And you'll take yourself under the yoke of bondage once again. Come on now. Hallelujah. Now Paul didn't play. He said, I have confidence in you through the Lord that you will be none otherwise minded. But he that troubled you shall bear his judgment whosoever he be. And I, brethren, if I yet preach circumcision, why do I yet suffer persecution? Then is the offense of the cross ceased? I would they were even cut off, which trouble you. That's pretty stern, weren't it? Because he cared about the people's souls. And he knowed that those that were troubling them, that was bringing in that perverted gospel, were dragging them off into hell. And he would rather see them cut off and taken out than to take all them souls to hell with them. And that's pretty serious. So what does God think about when we get our eyes off of him? It's serious. It's serious. It is serious. When we get our minds off the cross, get our eyes off the cross, get our faith off of what Christ has already done for us and put it someplace else, it's a serious deal. Listen, if we could save ourselves, Jesus would not have to come and die for us.
Can't do it. You can lay down all the things that we consider sin and still die and go to hell.
Because you didn't receive what Christ, you didn't believe of what he did for you at Calvary. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. For brethren, ye have been called unto liberty. Freedom. Liberty. But he gave them a little bit of a warning here. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this: thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Liberty. Remember I said we didn't have a license to sin. We're not to use that liberty as an occasion to the flesh. But we are to serve one another in love. And the law is fulfilled in love thy neighbor. Hallelujah. That's it. That's it. Love one another. Amen. Somebody get a song on, or I can, or whatever, but we'll have an altar call tonight. If anybody feels like they need to come and pray, please come. If you feel a drawing of the Spirit, come and pray. Or if you need prayer, please come and let us pray for you.
Pam sent a message. Pray for her and Stacy. They're at the ER. Both okay. of them sick.
All right. Everybody remember Sister Pam and Brother Stacy in prayer. And I need somebody to stand in for Sister Angel Witt tonight. She wants somebody to stand in for her tonight. And also, we'll pray for Pam and Stacy. Amen. Well, you know, the enemy's attacking people with sickness and everything else, amen. And he's attacking your minds with confusion, too, amen. God's not the author of confusion. We got to realize that. He's not the author of confusion. We got to close the doors to confusion and get away from it. Preacher warned me a long time ago. He said for me to stay away from strife and confusion. He gave me a word. Stay away from strife and confusion. And Brother Johnny, right before he died, he was so worried because he had a bad dream concerning me. And he said, stay away from anybody that's arguing, any argument. You know, stay away from it. Praise the Lord. You remember that, Ann? He didn't tell me what happened, dream didn't tell me what, but it was just something bad, amen, it had him tore up. So let's stay away from strife. Because the Bible teaches where there's strife and confusion at, there's every evil work.
Amen.
Every evil work. That's something to think about tonight, ain't it? Every evil work. Bring it down a little bit. Thank you, Lord. Bring it down just a little bit more, please. You feel like you need prayer, come on up and let us pray for you tonight. If somebody would, please come and stand in for Angel tonight, please. And you ladies, please. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. There's power in the name of Jesus. So stand up. Father God, as Candy stands in for Angel tonight, Lord, we ask, Lord, that you touch her tonight. God, move on her body tonight, God, and give her a miracle, Lord. You know what's going on, Lord. Ask, Lord, that you'll move on her now, oh God, and give her a miracle, Father God. Touch her heart, touch her in every area tonight, God. We claim and we believe in Ezekiel 16, verse 6, Lord. We claim it for her tonight, God. Move on her tonight, God. Encourage her tonight, Lord. And lift her up tonight, God. And help her tonight, God, we pray. In Jesus' name. And Lord, we ask that you move for Sister Pound and Brother Stacy, Lord. Touch their bodies, Lord, to heal them tonight, God, and strengthen them, Lord. Move that old sickness from them tonight, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Just move for them tonight, God. Move for them, God, in Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Is there anybody else tonight? Your healing's in the cross, folks. Everything you have need of is in the finished work of Calvary. Is in the finished work of Calvary. Noble city, devil soul, your peace of mind, your peace of heart, your victory over sin, your victory over oppression tonight. See, there's a difference between possession and oppression. I don't believe a true born-again child of God can be possessed by an evil spirit. I don't believe that. The reason I say I don't believe that, because where light dwelleth, no darkness can dwell. But he'll come at your mind. He'll come at your health. He'll come at your finances. He'll try to take your peace. He'll come at you through family. He'll come at you through your kids. Whatever he can get his hands to come on at you with, that's what he'll do. Come on now. He'll oppress you, but he can't possess you. Come on now. He'll try to make you think you're possessed. I'm serious. He'll try to make you think that you're possessed to get your eyes off of God. But let me tell you something. Hallelujah. Greater is he that's within you than he that's in the world. Come on, somebody need to hear me tonight. You need to get a victory shout tonight and say, I'm victorious because of my Jesus. I'm victorious because of Jesus. I feel anointed here tonight. Cast me away, that's fine. But Jesus had never cast me away. He'll never cast me away. He's proved that to me time after time. He's showed me that time after time. It's broken. We come from all different backgrounds. I don't know about you, but I don't fit in every church. I don't fit in every church. They don't want me. I'm not dressed fancy enough. I'm not educated enough. I'm a misfit. But God showed me what he's given us to misfits. But we fit perfectly together. And we make us that body. He's calling in little churches. He's calling nobodies, the outcasts, the misfits.
He's going to raise them up. He's going to raise them up.
He's going to raise them up. He's called his church out of the church. His church. The blood-bought church of Jesus Christ. That he bought and paid for at Calvary with his blood. The Bible teaches me that we are no longer our own. We were bought with a price. And it was the precious blood that was shed at Calvary. Anybody need prayer or not, please come and let us pray for you where the Spirit is moving. Thank you. Hallelujah. Somebody lift him up. Somebody exalt his name tonight. Can you see the walls crumbling? Can you see the walls crumbling? I see walls falling and people stepping across the ruins of them. A multitude. walls and stepping out of bondage into liberty. Take you so deep in what I tried to just preach tonight, and I know I fumbled and didn't do that good. But this goes so deep. So deep. I didn't even put a scratch tonight. I did that word. And you did. Control is witchcraft. It is done by man. You get what I'm saying? It's a form of witchcraft. It is done by man. Nobody's supposed to have control over us but God. Yes, I know there's order in the body. Don't take me wrong. And we're supposed to submit to the offices. We're so supposed to submit to the order of God. But that's submitting to God and His order and those He puts over us. Amen. But the puppet strings. Man. Controlling you. It's witchcraft. Hallelujah. I'm trying to shut up, folks. Thank you, Lord. Anybody else need prayer tonight? Thank you. Appreciate everybody tonight. Appreciate the good turnout tonight. Weather being like it's doing, amen. Although it's been pretty for a few days, but it looks spring. Thank God for that. So it's December. I heard Brother Webb back there pray, Lord, send me some spring weather. Hallelujah. I want everybody that will be praying for Sweetwater Church. You know, the devil messed up our gas line. We lost all our gas. So, you know, be praying about that. The Lord open the door and help us to get what we need. Brother Stacy fixed the gas line yesterday. You know, we just got to get the gas. I pray the Lord lead me in the right direction there. Which direction to go, how to go about it and everything. Amen. And just keep us in prayer. The enemy's tried his best, which he did here for a long time. He tried to drive me away from here. He tried to run me off where I've been stolen from. You name it, everything else been attacked. And, you know, you name it. Had a letter slid under the door by that guy called himself the Waster. I don't know if any of you remember that. It was on the news, slid it under the second when he was more or less was threatening everybody. You know, but you got to stand. You got to stand. You don't run from the devil. You stand. And I know a long time ago I could have walked off and left here. I come to this church and it ain't. I come to this church and nobody here. I could have walked off and left here. But I had to stand. Same thing with Sweetwater. Better stand. Better stand. Better stand. And I thank God for the webs. They've been a big help, folks. Been a real big help. God's used them to help me so much. Amen. I thank God for them. But Sweetwater. Amen. I appreciate them coming down here to be a part of us. Amen. I thank y'all. Amen. All of us. I'm not going to name the names. I'm going to miss somebody. Amen. But look, I thank God for the God and everything this was done. There wouldn't be no church here or in Sweetwater without you all. Amen. It ain't about me. We're the body. And I'm not the head. Jesus is. Somebody need to grab a hold of that. I'm not the head. Jesus is. Jesus is. Thank you all. But be praying for us, amen. And looking for mighty things happening for you. I'm not giving up because I know God connected me and put me there for a reason. Because I didn't want more. One church is enough. One church is enough, amen. But God has other ideals, amen. So praise the Lord for that, amen. Amen. I'm going to let everybody go if there's no... If there's nothing else, but if you need prayer, come on up. Don't leave without getting prayer if you need it tonight. And pray for one another. Remember all these prayer requests tonight. There might have been some more on Facebook. Remember them, amen. And praise the Lord. We love y'all. And good Lord will, and we'll see you next year. God bless you, each and every one. Shake hands with one another. God bless y'all.
Oh, praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.